Hello everyone and welcome to the channel or welcome back to the channel. In this video we are going to talk about an article that I came across that stated that 67% of married women want to cheat. My first thoughts were that this number was inflated because as you already know or should know that you can't really believe much of what is said in the media. But then again, times are different and people are more unrighteous and immoral. So let's talk about it. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like, comment and share the video, it's free. They say that it happens to the best of us. We're in a committed relationship for years. Then we realize, meh, the passion just isn't what it used to be. It might not be an easy thing to admit. He says, if you've ever felt that way, you're not alone. Eric Anderson, a professor of masculinity, sexuality, and sport at the University of Winchester, explains, the most predictable thing about a relationship is that the longer it progresses, the quality and the frequency of sex between the couple will fade. He said, this is because we get used to and bored of the same body. It seems like a very human response to monotony if you ask me. I need to stop here to say that this is wicked thinking and this is the thoughts and actions of whores. Virtuous women do not think this way and they do not cheat. Anderson also happens to be the chief science officer at Ashley Madison. If you've yet to hear of this site, then allow me to explain. It's a dating website for married people who are looking to have affairs. Depending on where you stand on morals, you may either think this is the worst thing in the world or it's a brilliant concept. He said, personally, I fall somewhere in the middle. As with any dating site, Ashley Madison definitely does their research. Anderson and his fellow scientists surveyed 100 straight married women between the ages of 25 and 45 to find out why women cheat. He wondered, why not just get a divorce? What they found was that 67% of the women just want some passion and sex back in their lives again. They want to be wined and dined and made to feel like they're appreciated and attractive again. What the study also found is that, of those women, zero of them wanted to get a divorce. In fact, as Anderson noted, they were adamant that they were not looking for a new husband. Many even stated their overt love for their husbands, painting them in a positive light. Your tango expert and writer, Charles J. Orlando, went undercover on Ashley Madison to see whether if he posed as a married guy looking to have a fling with a married woman, he could come to some understanding as to why women cheat. According to the Journal of Couple and Relationship Therapy, nearly 50% of married women and 60% of married men will have an extramarital affair at some point in their marriage. And since those percentages have doubled in the last 10 years, it only makes sense that we get to the heart of the matter and figure out why. Orlando went on a date with three women whom he referenced in his article. Not only did the three women share the same complaints like lack of passion and lack of attention, but it also seemed to be a constant theme with most of the women in their Ashley Madison profiles. At one point, he asked one date why she stayed with her husband, and she said, quite frankly, I love him. When a man begins dating a woman, he puts in tons of effort, he woos her. Once she's his, he stops putting in that effort, but she still longs for it. She wants to be desired, seduced, and connected with on a regular basis. So many men seem to be missing the boat. They start strong, having a decent sense of how to capture a woman at the beginning, but upon entering a relationship, they are unprepared for the long haul and investment a successful relationship demands past the dating phase. The situation starts to reek of complacency and satisfaction in mediocrity, says Orlando. She said, I've been married for less than 6 months, and I may not be at the stage where I'm searching for passion from another man, but even this early on in my relationship, she can say that marriage takes work. As Orlando put it more eloquently than she did, marriage doesn't take work, per se, but it does require concerted effort and investment in each other and in you. She couldn't agree more. Anyone will tell you there's a difference between love and sex, and the same goes for love and passion. Just because you love your husband, it doesn't mean you're giving them everything they need. If you want to be in it to win it, you need to step up your game. He said, I don't condone cheating, but I don't condemn it either. But I need to stop here to disagree, and I have to say that cheating has real consequences. The article goes on to say, I also don't think we should fault a woman whose husband hasn't paid attention to her in years, sexually or otherwise, for cheating. We're sexual beings, and having desires and wanting to be desired is just how we're made. But let me tell you that, as a woman, if you are bored in your marriage, learn a craft, learn how to knit or crochet. Learn how to grow a garden and how to can food, something constructive and not destructive, because cheating on your husband is just a trashy thing to do. And we are not sexual beings. This wicked world has pushed that false myth, and they have people with these desires and wants. Because everything has been sexualized, from the cartoons to the television shows and every movie to the music. Women have become perverts. The United States has sexualized everything. Women talk about sex now more than men. Do you know that more men today are virgins than women? The article goes on to say, if anything Ashley Madison appears to be doing, a great service to these women whose husbands appear to have forgotten them. She said, honestly, that's something she never thought she would say. But these women do not understand that infidelity can have long-term effects on the quality of your relationship. But this type of thinking is what whores do. Every wise woman builds her house, but the foolish plucks it down with her hands. The father said, teach the women to be good wives. A good wife does not cheat on her husband. That is the actions of a wicked woman. You may have cheated on your husband and find yourself surprised by the consequences of that decision. Infidelity can have lasting impacts on your husband and children that you too may have. Grief, brain changes, behaviors down the road, and mental health conditions such as anxiety, chronic stress, and depression can follow. A lot of women are deleted by their husbands because of cheating. Some families have been able to move past infidelity with time. But guilt and shame are big components of adultery. Infidelity is a mark in his heart. It's embarrassing to the husband. But even in more situations, it's the husband who feels most of the embarrassment and shame. A fatal consequence of adultery is broken trust and loss of intimacy. Statistics vary on the subject, but it's widely reported that 40% of women will participate in an extramarital affair at some point during their married life. It's the depth of betrayal and emotional pain that often leads to divorce after infidelity. Such negative emotions are hard to put behind you, and many men feel there is no way to rebuild trust in the marriage. If you have found yourself in this situation, take heart. Your negative emotions will eventually fade, and your life will become normal again. Adultery is one of the worst things that can happen to a marriage and violates everything you've built with your husband in such a personal way. Many husbands did not see it coming. They were blindsided. Infidelity can feel like a death, the death of trust, the death of affection, the death of all the work you've done in your marriage. The fatal blow to any marriage is an adulterous affair where one or both spouses think they finally found his wife. The creator of the heavens and the earth created said he who finds a wife should find a good thing for women to behave as becoming and tasteful. As a woman, we are to act and react with class, dignity, honor, and respect because we are the daughters of the Most High. Cheating on your husband makes you a filthy dog. A cheating woman convinces a man that he married the wrong woman. The creator gives the man permission to divorce his wife for infidelity. Blinded by the deception of the affair, most of the men have no idea how they got there. There's no doubt about it, adultery affects marriages in the worst way. Cheating is one of the easiest ways to damage a relationship. The reason infidelity is the closest thing to impossible to resolve and work through is because it completely shatters the most basic foundation of a relationship, trust. Cheating can collapse even the strongest bonds and is especially dangerous because it has the power to implode your relationship. Don't cheat on your spouse unless you're ready for some major consequences. The aged women likewise, that they be in behavior as becometh holiness, not false accusers, not given to much wine, teachers of good things, that they may teach the young women to be sober, to love their husbands, to love their children, to be discreet, chaste, keepers at home, good, obedient to their own husbands, that the word of the Most High be not blasphemed. Cheating is just wrong. It is selfish, self-centered, and self-serving. We all want to feel appreciated because it elicits the idea that our existence matters to someone else. It makes us feel valued and cherished because being appreciated is how we recognize that we're important to others and that our presence does make a difference in someone's life. If you want to be wined and dined, just ask your husband. Almost everything is against you being a good wife, the television shows, the movies, and the music. The entertainment in this world shows you how to be a cheating, disobedient, bad wife. How to lie, cheat, and drink a lot of wine. How to disrespect yourself and your husband. You need to understand what you are looking at and what you are listening to is created to destroy you. There are many songs glorifying being a cheating woman. There are certain qualities that almost every man looks for in a woman, and deceitfulness is not one of them. A good wife acts with wisdom. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, leave a like and a comment. And if it is your first time on the channel, don't forget to subscribe. Until next time.